Hi everyone, my name is Drew Ross. I'm the band director at Greybridge High School, and I wanted to make a recap video from last night's marching band information night meeting. Hope this video will help you out. If you have any questions, you can watch the video, stop it, pause it, rewind, whatever. If there's something in the video that doesn't answer the question you might have, you can always reach out to me through email. My email is drew.ross@cpschools.com. Feel free to email me anytime. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Our marching band is one of the most visible and spirited groups at the high school. We perform for a number of different activities, including football games, parades, pep rallies, that kind of thing. We also do a field show that's part of a competition season that we do. So we kind of perform for ourselves and for the school community. The kind of mix between the two is pretty exciting and pretty fun for everybody involved. I think that you should join marching band because it's one of the best groups at school. The freshmen have a chance to meet a bunch of new people and have some guidance when they go down the hallways for the first time. They also have 3 years worth of students that they can talk to who have experienced a number of different things that they're going to go through. And also, it's a lot of fun for the students to come together and put our show together and clean it and perform. So our students keep coming back every year. Because of the friendships, I think that the friendships they develop are really, really special, and that's what keeps this thing going. Okay, as far as the schedule goes, we have a drumline and guard camp that starts the week of August 8th. That'll be in the evenings. August 15th and August 22nd are the two beginnings of the two band camp weeks we have for everyone. We rehearse Monday through Thursday. We don't do Fridays during band camp. And we rehearse from 12:30 to 5 p.m. and then 6 to 9 p.m. And that's where we learn most of our show. The following week, the week before school starts, is a week with a couple of rehearsals. We also, on August 30th, will have our parent night or parent preview over at the middle school stadium where we will perform our show or what we've learned so far for the parents. It'll be kind of be our first performance in public. Band fees are listed on the page here, but basically, a lot of the expenses that are involved for marching band are not supported financially through the school division. That includes show design, instructional staff, transportation to some of our competitions. You know, there's a number of different things, equipment, you know, you name it, that we have to pay through a fee and through fundraising. So the fees are on the page here. I'm going to switch to a slide now that has a breakdown of the different fee types. And it also has information about paying via PayPal or Square. PayPal is probably easier to me for me to talk about here because the Square option is more for in person. But basically, you can pay your fees to treasurer@gbhsband.org. Just make sure that you click the goods and services for the for part of that. And you can pay fees that way. You can also send a check to the school, and the address is where is there it is 301 West Hanbury Road. Just make sure that my name is on there somewhere. If you want to put marching band deposit or marching band or marching Wildcats application, whatever on the envelope, that's very helpful. And you can also send things in that way in July for the second payment. If you don't want to come up to the school when the drumline or guard are having rehearsals to do that, just a couple of links to our social media or plugs. Great Bridge Band is the handle for Twitter and Instagram, and you can also find the Marching Wildcats official Facebook page. We also use an app called Band, which is probably, I think, the most important one to join. And that's where parents ask questions. Other parents can answer the questions. I can answer questions. You know, that kind of stuff. It also has a link to the calendar in there. Some files can be shared through that. We use Remind to communicate information out to the band parents and students. There are two different Remind groups. There's the family one or the band parent one, and there's a student one also. The student one is more specific to rehearsal times, where we're going, meeting locations, little details that when we're traveling. The band parent one is more for when we're returning from an event, or if there's a delay or whatever. I'll send out messages through the band parent remind just so you're up to date with what's going on and where we're located and all that. As far as registration for the marching band season goes, you're going to want to visit gbhsband.org. it'll redirect you to this gbhsband.membershiptoolkit.com. That's just the site that runs our database that we use for the program and also hosts our website. So it's going to look a little different when you get onto the page. I will log out just to kind of show you what I mean. You'll have this welcome, and if you're a returning user, you just enter your email address and your password. If you forgot it, you know, click forgot my password. If you're a new family joining the band program, you're going to want to create an account. So you just click on there and then fill out the form. It's pretty straightforward. You're going to have to enter some things a couple times, but that's how you get hooked up to our membership toolkit stuff, is by joining this part. Once you've done that, you'll be able to log in and you will see the main page. All right. Now here, you're going to want to click, there's a couple places. You can go to My Account and you'll see a thing that says My Forms and Paperwork. If you click on that, it should show you a couple different forms. Now, mine looks, again, a little different. We have some draft forms and things in here. But for you, the information forms should pop up, and it should say 2022 Great Bridge Marching Wildcats application. Click on that, fill out the information here, and once you're done with all that, submit. Okay, once that's done, the second part of it is just paying the deposit, which is again due June 3rd. It's $100. So once you get everything hooked up here, you should be good, and we'll have your student registered. You will have to register each student if you have multiple siblings in the program. So just a heads up with that. You'll have to fill the form out both times, but you should be able to keep the same account, so you don't have to do all that twice. While I'm here and have your attention, if you click on My Account again and go to Calendar Subscriptions, you can actually subscribe to the different calendars that we have, or calendar, I should say, which is down here at the bottom. And we have some newsletters, too, that you can subscribe to. You're automatically subscribed to them, I believe. But if you're not, you want to make sure you sign up for those. We'll make sure that the newsletters get out to everybody. But this one's important here, signing up and subscribing for the calendar. Once you click it, it'll let you pick if you want to use, hook it up with Google or whatever you use to manage your calendar. And then all of the information about rehearsals and all will sync up with your device. The same calendar that's here is on the Band app also. I edit the calendar on Membership Toolkit and it pushes everything to the Band app. So you'll have the same information in both places. If you have any questions about subscribing or joining the Membership Toolkit site, you can send me an email and I'd be happy to help you out. All right, that pretty much wraps it up. If you have any questions, again, you can always email me. drew.ross@cpschools.com is the way to do that. And thank you all very much. Look forward to getting the season started.